coral reef is the most diverse kind of life in the ocean.
Everything you've done to get ready for all this research activities, you're finally out there, you're finally on site, you finally get to get in the water and do your thing.
It's definitely important for these Caribbean reefs to be preserved, just as we preserve our own reefs off the Texas coast.
The waters from the Caribbean flow up to Texas. We are literally connected to Mexico and to the Caribbean by waters that flow through there.
I am Wes Tunnell, director of the Center for Coastal Studies at Texas A&M University in Corpus Christi. This is our 25th year of going to Mexico. It's a graduate class in ecology to allow the students the opportunity to experience a coral reef firsthand. Many people in Texas don't realize that they have a coral reef about 100 miles off Galveston, out on the edge of the continental shelf, the flower gardens. And so the corals, fish, other invertebrates that are there, their source bed of larvae for the future and current days is coming from Mexico.
Our waters in the Gulf of Mexico come from the Caribbean Sea. A very strong current from the Caribbean flows from the south into the Gulf of Mexico. As it comes in, it divides and sweeps around the eastern side of the Gulf of Mexico and then up to the Texas coast. And so we can say that we are literally connected to the Caribbean by the flow of water that comes into the Gulf of Mexico. We started going to the reefs in Veracruz in the early 1970s. The footage is really a historical window into what was there. We look back now to see the greater diversity and abundance of life that was there. What we see now is just barren rock, or the skeletons of the corals that are covered over by a small fuzz of algae that covers the surface of all these once living corals. In heavily populated human areas, we see these same kinds of impacts taking place, and Veracruz is kind of a model of what you shouldn't be doing. This study site we're at now is called the Cancun Biosphere Reserve. We're finding, fortunately, in the Yucatan area that the reefs are nice and healthy. The students really benefit from this expeditionary opportunity that they have. It makes the students aware that we need to be good stewards of the land and the natural resources and the ocean in order to protect those.
My name's Addie Fretz, and I'm a graduate student working on my master's degree at Texas A&M Corpus Christi. The world's oceans are the last frontier on this earth, and I love being underwater, and I've always dove ever since I was little. So every time I go, it's just a thrill each and every time. I love doing research underwater because it's such a complex and fascinating environment. The basis of my research is to take photographs of the coral and to compare that to photographs I took at the flower gardens, which is the coral reef right off the coast of Texas, and try to see what's similar and what's different about the two sites. This is one of the slides that I took in Mexico. I took 36 slides to try to figure out what kind of corals were out there and how often they occur. And then I put a series of 100 random dots in each slide, and I identify the species that is under each dot. So in that way, I can compare that to what I've found at the flower gardens. This is a shot taken the same way as the ones in Mexico of the flower gardens. There are a lot of similarities. For instance, this same alga is found in both places, as is this alga. What's surprising is how similar these reefs actually are. In the species composition, we find a lot of the same species at both the flower gardens and in Mexico.
My name is Derek Hagman, and I'm a graduate student in the field of molecular marine biology.
You never really know what you're going to see when you jump in the water. Even on a site you've been diving on for years, there's always a potential for something new that you've never seen before. What we're just really looking for is trying to get genetic evidence that supports that the current that comes out of the Caribbean into the Gulf of Mexico is the ultimate source of populations in the Gulf of Mexico. Once the fish has been speared, just transport back to the lab to conduct the necessary analysis of the DNA.
So this is one of the fish that was collected off of the Yucatan Peninsula, and what we'd like to do now is collect some of the tissue from this individual, and then we'll isolate the DNA from that and use that to compare with similar samples from other fish collected either off Texas or other parts of the Caribbean. So here we're looking at the DNA to screen for something called an allele, and these alleles will be helpful in distinguishing between the populations of Texas and the Caribbean. We have to look at the genetic structure, or the genes, basically. After finishing the genetic screening, we produce this image that displays the different character states of our gene that we're studying for these three sites. We have two different alleles for this gene, and it's found at all three sites, which means that these three sites are, in fact, interconnected, that there is genetic exchange that takes place. There really is a Caribbean connection.
The interconnectivity should concern us in Texas because of our nearness to Mexico and to the Caribbean. We are literally connected to Mexico and to the Caribbean by waters that flow through there. So we as humans need to be careful in how we impact waters in Mexico that may eventually affect Texas waters.
It's very complex. It's also very fragile. And we as human beings need to be good stewards of our ocean environment.